Hi friends, welcome back to Joe Educare. Today in this video we are going to discuss how to solve a problem using KVL and KCL. So let's get into the video. So in this, you have to find the currents in the various branches of the given network shown below. So this is the network they were given. You have to find out the various branches, okay, current in the various branches. It is nothing but branch current you have to find out. So this network resembles like hexagonal. So hexagonal nothing but six sides you have. So totally six branches you have here. You can see here one branch is A, B, B, C, C, D, D to E, E, F and F to A. So totally six branches are there. So you are going to find the six branch current, okay, to each branches. So you can see here from A to B, they have given the branch current as I. So they have given the branch current as I, they already given. But in the other branches you can see there, they have not given any branch current. So before finding the branch current, you have to draw the branch current directions. You have to draw, that is very important. So to draw the branch current, first we'll just see how to draw the branch current directions, we'll see. So for that, what you have to do is we have to apply KCL, Kirchhoff's current law. Okay, so already I've explained in the other videos. You can just check out the other videos regarding Kirchhoff's current law. So here, first thing what you have to do is, this circuit is nothing but what, little bit complicated. It is not so simple circuit, so you can't use Ohm's law for this particular circuit. So other option will be Kirchhoff's law. So in the Kirchhoff's law, you have to use, there are two laws, one is voltage and current law. So voltage law is nothing but mesh law or loop law. So here you can see inside a one loop, which is nothing but a closed circuit. You can see only one loop is there. So before that, what I told is we have to find out the branch current. So we just require the current branch direction we require. So that's why first thing we'll apply is KCL. So here you can see here at this particular point. So from A, they've already drawn the branch current direction. They've already given as I. So next thing is from B, what is the current direction? That's what we are going to find out. So we'll apply KCL step by step. We'll see. We'll apply KCL first for the point B. Okay. So at point B, what will be the current direction? We'll just see by applying KCL. So according to KCL, it is nothing but sum of current entering to the junction is equal to sum of current leaving the junction. Okay. So this is nothing but a junction or a point B. So what is the current entering here? You can see here I is entering. Okay, next you can see here something is leaving from the point B, which is 80 amps they were given. So 80 is leaving, so minus 80. Okay, so I minus 80. So that's what is the current direction for branch B to C. Okay, so I minus 80 will be the current direction. This is how we have to find the branch current directions for all the other branches. Similarly, we'll find out. Okay, so point B is over. Next, we'll find similarly by using same thing KCL at point C. At point C, we'll see now what to do. So you see, at point C, you can see current entering is I minus 80, which is entering. So we have taken as positive. Next, at point C, you can see one more current is, it is also entering, it is not leaving. Okay, so plus 90. So what you will get is, after simplification, get I plus 10. Okay, so from branch C, the current will be I plus 10. Next, from D, you have to find out. So next, we'll find out at point D. So from point D, you can see here, entering current is I plus 10, that is from point C. Next, leaving is 150. So leaving means you have to take negative 150 minus. So what you'll get is I minus 140. So that will be the current direction from branch D to E. So I minus 140. Next, same thing we'll see at point E. So next, at point E, same thing. Now I minus 140 is entering to the point E. So entering means you have to take positive Okay, so plus I minus 140. Next, you can see at the point E, 120 is also entering. So plus 120. So after simplification, what you'll get, I minus 140 plus 120 will be I minus 20. Okay, so I minus 20 will be the current direction from E to F, I minus 20. Next, at point F, okay, we'll just find out what will be the current direction at point F. So at point F, I minus 20 is entering. So take it as positive, I minus 20 is entering. So here from point F, 80 ohm is leaving. So take it as minus. So the leaving current is taken as negative. So now after simplification, what you'll get is I minus 100. Okay, so this I minus 100 will be the current leaving from point F. The next last point is nothing but A. So last junction is nothing but point A or junction A. Same thing, we'll apply KCL at point junction as well. So here at point or junction A, entering current is I minus 100, and one more current is entering, that is also entering 100 amps. So I have to add it. Now after simplification, what you'll get is I. So that's what they have given in the question. You can see from point A, I is the current which is leaving to the branch towards B. Okay, so this is the way to find out all the branch directions. So after finding the branch directions, next thing what you have to do is, so what they have asked is to find out the currents in the various branches. So you have to find out the current in the various branches. So you can see, to find the current through six branches, you totally have six branches. You can see here, in this particular branch, I is the current flowing. So next branch, B to C, I minus 80 is the current flowing. Next branch, C to D, I plus 10 is the branch current. So totally you can see throughout all the branches, if you find the current I, it will be easy to find all the branch current. So that's why what you'll do is, next target is to find the current I. Okay, so if you know the value of I, it is easy to find. So for that, what you have to do is, you have to apply KVL, that is nothing but Kirchhoff's voltage law. So you can see here, you have only one loop. So just randomly you draw the loop directions. I'll draw the loop direction randomly. So you can see here all the current directions, which shows that it is rotating in the clockwise direction. So that's why I'm drawing the loop direction in the clockwise. It is left to you. You can draw it in any ways. Okay, according to that, you have to apply KVL. So we'll apply KVL. You'll get the answer. So we'll discuss how to apply the KVL. So now, next step is to apply KVL for this network. So according to KVL, you know that summation of I R is equal to summation of E. So this is the statement, equation what you'll get from the statement Kirchhoff's voltage law. So we'll apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law to this network. How to apply? So in the left hand side, you can see it is nothing but summation of algebraic sum of product of current and resistance, okay, which is equal to algebraic sum of all the EMFs. So resistance, you can see whether you can see any resistance here. They have not drawn the resistance symbol directly, but they have given the value. You can see here 0.02 ohm, 0.03 ohm. So ohm is nothing but unit of resistance. So indirectly they have given the resistance for particular branches, okay, but they have not drawn the resistance symbol. So it means that they have given the resistance. So what you have to do is, the simple thing is, just the resistance, number of resistance will just count. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 resistance are there. So in the left hand side, you can see the equation of KVL. It is nothing but algebraic sum of product of current and resistance. So totally 6 resistance are there. First thing is, we will just add all the resistance value. So starting from this branch, AB branches, 0.02. So we'll just add 0.02. Okay, so then here you can see it is multiplied with the current. So we'll leave some space for current, plus resistance is there, right? We'll just add a second resistance, that is same thing, 0.02, plus we'll leave some space for current. Next, third resistance is 0.03, plus fourth resistance 0.02, Next 0.01. Last one is also 0.01. Okay, so total we have added all the resistance, which is equal to, in the right hand side you can see summation of all the EMFs, but in this you don't have any EMF, so that's why it will be zero. That's why it will be zero. So now it is not at completed, you have to multiply with the current flowing to that particular resistance. So we'll just keep on multiplying. So for first resistance, I is the current flowing, so this will be into I. Next, for second resistance, I minus 80, so this will be I minus 80. Similarly, fill everything. So for this, I plus 10. Next, I minus 140. Next, I minus 20. The last one, I minus 100. Okay, so now we'll simplify this, then we can easily find out the value of I. Why? Because you have only one unknown throughout the equation, so it is easy to find out the value of I. So we'll just start to simplify. So we'll just add all the items together, so we'll get, then we'll add all the numericals, we'll get minus 5.3 is equal to 0. Now you can easily simplify this, take this to right hand side, you'll get 5.3. Now I will be equal to, after simplification you will get 48.18 amps. So this is the way to find out the current I. Okay, so once after finding the current I, it is easy to find out the branch current. To various branches you can easily find out, so I'll just write how to find out. So first thing is branch AB. Okay, through branch AB we'll just write it as I AB. Okay, so what is the current flowing through this branch? I is the current flowing, so I, you got the value as 48.18 amps. So this is the current through branch AB. So another branch we'll find for BC. For BC you can see I minus 80 is the current flowing, so we'll write I minus 80. So we'll substitute I is nothing but 48.18 minus 80, you will get minus 31.82 amps. So this is the current through the branch BC. So if you want to write it positive, you can interchange the branches. So BC, if I interchange, if the current is flowing from C to B, from C to B, if I interchange, you can write it as plus 31.82 amps. Okay, you can write either minus 31.82 from B to C. If it is flowing from C to B, it will be positive. So you can just put R and you can write either of one. So after that, next branch C to D. C to D. So current flowing is C to D, current is flowing I plus 10. So I, you know, 48.18 plus 10, you will get 58.18 amps. So CD is over. Next, D to E. So D to E, current flowing is I minus 140. So 48.18 is I minus 140, you will get as around minus 91.82 amps. So this is something but I DE, current flowing from D to E. So if I want to get positive value, I can just interchange the branches. E to D, I will get positive value plus 91.82 amps. So next, E to F. So for E to F, so this is D to E branch. Next, E to F, the current flowing is I minus 20. I minus 20. So just substitute, I is 48.18 minus 20. I'll get 28.18 amps. So this will be the current flowing to the branch E to F. So last one remaining is F to A. The current is I minus 100. So you can write after interchanging A to F is equal to, you'll get positive answer. This minus will become plus 51.82 amps. So this will be the answer for all the branches.
Bible verse to meditate on.
If you look for me wholeheartedly, you will find me. Jeremiah 29:13. Amen.
Check out other videos in my channel regarding Basic Electrical and Diploma Mathematics 1. Please support this channel by subscribing to Joe Educare and click on the bell button to get the notification regarding new videos. Thank you. God bless you all. Bye.